So it's not always that we need a polling firm. It's not necessary. And even in the U.S., when we work with some very local areas, when the resources are not available, we will have students assist, or we will do very simple ways of doing random sampling. But what's important is to make sure we are aware of what the resources are for us, and we work with what's available. And of course, we have to think about interviewers, whether men or women will be interviewing, or and how much training we can provide. It's very important that interviewers get a suitable amount of training, because interviewers are basically the first contact for us with the potential participants. So we have to make sure that they represent a very appropriately. The next slide here is a lot of words here, but what I'm trying to say is that we take recruitment very seriously, and what we really focus on is the number of callbacks, or if we're doing it face-to-face, the number of revisits that we make. So to us, once we've decided on a population, and once we've sampled the population, we make every effort to reach every single person. And what I mean is that there are some polling firms, and I'm sure all of us are very aware of places that do polling quarterly. They may, because of various reasons, just call someone once and not try again. We ask our interviewers to try at least 5, 7 times, maybe 10 times, trying to reach someone at different times of the day. And we do this because once one person and the whole group is selected into our sample, we want to make every effort to reach them. And this is something that we have to monitor. And when we figure out what kind of polling method we will use, we will have to train the interviewers very carefully to let them know that this is very important to us. Now, the next slide, just to share with you a little bit, when we actually do the recruitment, in the first survey that they implement with the participants, we give the interviewers all a script. So we make sure that the interviewers are saying the same thing every time they interview somebody. And this is very common, and so I think that everyone would be used to this. But in our script, definitely, and we can provide samples of this, we have them complete a survey, invite them to the event, and then we tell them what things are available because of the event. Maybe there is incentives for participating. Maybe we're giving them transportation, or perhaps there are some prizes or a special event at the deliberative poll, and we put that into the script so that the interviewers can share this information. And next slide here is, once we've done the initial survey, there's always some time in between when the survey is asked to when the actual event is. So it could be maybe a month or 2 months before the actual event. And which means that we have to have a plan of how to remind and keep reminding the participants that they promised to go do usually is we have a plan to say, well, on this day we will call them to confirm, and on another day we will send them briefing material. On another day we will reconfirm maybe by phone or reconfirm in person. So we try to plan out ways to ensure that people always remember that they had promised to attend our event. And this is important because we are very busy. Most people are very busy, and we have to make sure that they remember that this is